Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's get a general and complete overview on how to use MAGIX Movie Studio Platinum 15 in a short time. Leave us tips and suggestions below this video to improve our next video guides on Movie Studio. MAGIX Movie Studio is a great video editing software with all the most basic and important features from Vegas Pro in a compact user interface, made easier and focused on personal and customized video projects. In this video, we will get the fundamental features you need to start for the first time. When opening Movie Studio, its interface shows up with the latest project saved. You can browse for an existing project by going to Project and then to Open. To create a new empty project, use New instead. On the New Project dialog box, choose the standard format under Region, the audio format under Audio, and then the main template to use under Video. Under Project, fix the pixel resolution and the frame rate. At the bottom, type the project name and where to save it under Folder. The main workspace is divided in two. On top, you have several useful panels with everything you need to create your video, such as media, transitions, and effects. And at the bottom, you have the timeline. That is the place where you edit, adjust, and preview your project. Each panel has its name on the tab with a cross button used to close it. To reopen the panel, just go to View, Window, and then choose it from the list. To start creating your video, you have to import your media files first, which can be images, videos, or sound files. You can browse for these from the Explorer panel and add them by dragging and dropping them inside the timeline. You can also slide them from any of your folders directly. All the media files imported on the timeline are shown as blocks called events, with their own file name and quick editing buttons on top, and either thumbnails or sound waveforms at the bottom, depending on the kind of media. You can check these better by zooming in and out the timeline with your mouse wheel. The project timeline is divided in several rows called tracks. Images and video frames are collected inside video tracks with a frame icon on the extreme left. And audio files are placed inside audio tracks with a speaker icon instead. By default, a new project starts with three video tracks and two audio tracks, but you can add others by right-clicking on the tracks themselves. You can also adjust the track's height by dragging their edges. This will also size the thumbnail and the waveform preview on the events. On the right, the video preview shows the timeline content exactly where the white marker is placed at the bottom. You can click on the timeline to fix it in time and check a particular frame. If you click and hold on your pointer, you move the marker in time as you like, in order to check your project frame after frame without any audio. This also creates a blue loop region used to select a limited section of your overall project. To play back everything, including audio, you have to use the player below the preview. You can also check all in full screen mode by clicking on External Monitor on top, using the Enter key to play and pause, and the Escape key to exit. You also have several buttons to adjust the preview settings, but consider that these do not affect the final video that you are going to render. Use Project Video Properties to set resolution size, frame rate, and audio settings for the preview. And use Preview Quality to choose the quality to use. Pay attention that a high quality may affect the overall performance of your computer. Now, let's see how to edit the events inside the timeline. You can move an event in time by clicking and dragging it within the same track or in another. If you have a video with sound, its audio part is grouped with its frames together, so you always move both of them. You can make these independent by clicking on them and using the U key. At this point, if you move the audio part, this shows a red background, indicating that it is no longer synchronized with the video frames. To group them again, select them both with the Control key down and then use the G key. In case you get events overlapping in time, the video preview shows the events collected on the higher video tracks in front of all the events placed on the tracks lower in position from top to bottom. For this reason, Movie Studio starts with two important video tracks. The text track on top should contain all the titles, since it is the highest video track of the project, and shows text above any visual event. The second video track is called Picture in Picture, which is used to show a visible event on another at the same time. You can also move and size such media by clicking on the Tracks FX button and using the Video Preview directly. To stretch or shorten events in time, just click and drag from their edges. In case you stretch video and audio events over their default duration, these will be simply put in loop every time you see a down arrow at the top of them. Whereas, when you shorten these, you will just cut part of their content. So in case you do not want to change or loop the content of these events, you have to stretch or shorten them by holding down the Control key. This time stretch feature allows to change the event duration by acting on its speed rate and not its content. So if the event is stretched, this is played slower. If this is shortened, it is played faster to last less. Remember to use Control and Z to undo any action if you make a mistake. To cut, copy, or delete an event, just right-click on it. If you have any loop region active on the event, just the part within it will be affected by your modifications. To split an event, just click on it to select it. Place the timeline marker, and then use the S key. You can join up the splitted pieces anytime by selecting all of them, right-clicking, and going to Event Heal. In addition, each event has an envelope line that you can pull up or down. In case of picture and video frames, this changes the transparency level of the event. On audio events, this sets the overall volume level. Moreover, if you click and drag the inner corners, you can also apply fade-in and fade-out transitions that change the envelope line in time in order to introduce or exit from the event content in a cool way. In case of visual events, these fade transitions simply change the transparency level in time, but you can add special effects to them by using the Transitions panel. Here, choose your favorite effect and just drag and drop it on the extreme edges of the event. At this point, the Video Event FX window shows up in order to adjust the transition effect properties while checking the preview. You can reopen this window anytime by clicking on Transition Properties. To adjust the transition duration, just stretch its edges on the event itself. These transitions can also be applied between two overlapping events in order to go from one event to the next one through a great effect. With Movie Studio, you can apply amazing visual and audio effects to your media. On visual events, you can click on the Event Pan Crop button to zoom and crop their content. This opens the Video Event FX window on the Pan Crop page, as you can see on the plug-in chain at the top. Here, you can move, size, and rotate the rectangle you see to change the appearance of your event while checking the video preview. In fact, the rectangle represents the perimeter of your project content. You can also disable lock aspect ratio to size the rectangle freely and crop the event content as you need. You can also apply amazing visual effects with the Video FX panel. Here, you can browse for your favorite visual effect and then drag and drop it on an interested event to add it. The Video Event FX window will open on such effect page, showing all of its properties. As you add visual effects, these will be part of the event plugin chain on top, all placed right after the pan crop page. You can enable and disable each effect by clicking on the square, and change the effect position by clicking and dragging it through the chain. On sound clips, use the Event FX button to browse for the audio effects available. In this case, you will use Audio Event FX Panel to adjust all the effect properties. To add text and titles inside your project, open the Media Generators window. This collects several useful media, from backgrounds to text templates, animated and not animated. Choose one of the text templates to drag and drop it on a video track to create a title event. Just make sure to use a top video track in order not to get the title covered by other media. Then you can use the Video Media Generators window to adjust the text appearance, content, font, style, color, and animation if present. You can open this window anytime with the Generated Media button. The title event is just like a visible event, so you can use Event Pan Crop and Event FX to size, crop, or add effects. On the extreme left, you have several options to manage the content of all the video and the audio tracks. Use the Mute button to disable or enable the whole content of a track. The Solo button disables all the tracks of the same kind, leaving the interested track solo. Moreover, video tracks also have the Track FX button, used to add visual effects on the whole track content as seen for single events. Whereas audio tracks show two bars, the first one adjusts the volume level, and the second one the panning, to set the correct balance between the stereo channels. Let's see how to save and export your project. To save your project, go to the Save button in the top left corner. To export your project content on a video or online, just click on Make Movie on top and choose whether to upload your project on Vimeo, YouTube, or Facebook, to burn it onto a disk, or to export it to a video file, either for cameras, devices, or your own computer. In case you choose to save to an hard drive, give a video name on top and choose the video format at the bottom. For the full list of video settings, go to Advanced Options and choose your favorite template under Formats and then Templates. The MAGIX ABC AAC MP4 format is one of the best, offering a 4K resolution and a fast rendering due to the Intel QSV and the NVENC technology for NVIDIA graphics. More below, set where to save the video, and then go to Render to start rendering. The project will be exported entirely until the end of the last event on the timeline. You can choose the part to render by creating a blue loop region on the timeline, and then enabling the option Render Loop Region Only. Thanks for watching this video. Leave us comments and subscribe for more and free video guides to start learning professional software.